Dear students, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Deepika Goswami, working as scientist in Food Science and Technology in the Food Grains and Oilseed Processing Division of ICAR, Central Institute of Post Harvest Engineering and Technology, Ludhiana. Biscuits are small round bakery products leavened with baking powder or baking soda. We can see numerous types of biscuits in market, which vary in their shape, size and taste. These are mass consumption items eaten by all segments of the society. In this module, we will learn about the BIS, UK and USA classification of biscuits, the ingredients and the manufacturing of these bakery products, the operations like mixing, forming or shaping, baking and cooling, as well as the machinery used will be elaborated. Biscuits, first of all, what the term biscuit is? Biscuit, it refers to the small round bread leavened with baking powder or soda and covers a large variety of sweet biscuits, salted biscuits and coated biscuits. Biscuits are eaten by all sections of people across the board round the year. They are thus mass consumption items with number of varieties and shapes. The market is scattered. There are some dominant national and regional brands which produces biscuits. These can be manufactured at a location which is close to the market. The basic ingredients of biscuits are flour, baking powder, salt, baking soda, sugar, shortening, and milk solids. Bakery products. Biscuits, including wafer biscuits, shall be made from maida, vanaspati, or refined oil, or table butter, desi butter, margarine, ghee, or their mixture. Here is listed some common ingredients used for the biscuit preparation. As we can see, edible common salt, milk powder, coconut, fruits and fruit products, egg, ginger, butter, coffee extract, dry fruit and nuts, gluten, ground flour, milk and milk products, oil seeds, spices and condiments, starch, invert sugar, jaggery, protein concentrates, vinegar. So here are number of ingredients which may be used for the preparation of biscuits, and it totally depends on the consumer desire and their requirement. It also says that provided that the ash insoluble in dilute hydrochloric acid on dry basis shall not be more than 0.1%, the acidity of extracted fat as oleic acid should not exceed 1.5%. Classification of the biscuits on the basis of chemical composition and processing methodology is difficult due to their overlap. These are manufactured in varieties covering sweet, salted, filled and coated biscuits. There are mainly three types of classification of biscuits. First is the BIS classification. The varietal differences of biscuits can be easily distinguished based on their sensory attributes. Hence, BIS classifies the biscuits on the sensory basis into sweet, semi-sweet, crackers, cookies and speciality biscuits. Biscuit has nowadays become a food item of mass consumption and has got wide acceptance among all the levels and class of consumers. The UK classification of biscuits, it classifies the biscuits into hard dough biscuit and short dough biscuit. In the hard dough biscuit, the dough used is similar to the bread dough. The mixing of flour is more to maximize the gluten development. Hence, the dough is elastic and extensible due to the well-developed gluten network during mixing. These have very low fat and sugar content relative to the flour. Crackers, sweet and semi-sweet biscuits are certain examples of hard dough biscuit. In the short dough biscuit, the dough more closely relates to the cake dough. However, water used is lesser than the cake dough. Here, the mixing of flour is very little to minimize the gluten development. Higher fat or shortening than hard dough, resulting into lower extensibility of gluten, and hence there is easy breaking of the biscuits. There is higher sugar in the formulation of the short dough biscuit. A subgroup of short dough biscuit with a more soft consistency, which can be attributed to its higher sugar and fat content. The USA classification of biscuits is based on the method of processing and in particular on the basis of the way biscuits are shaped. The first one is the sheeting or cutting type. The dough is passed through laminators to produce sheets which are then fused into single sheet of desired thickness. This sheet is then passed on to cutter of various shape and sizes of cups or dies. The examples are cream crackers, puff crackers, marigold, salt and sugar cracker, 50-50, etc. Another one is the rotary molding type. The dough is in short crumb form and is directly fed into rotary molder with dies of various shape and size. Good Day, Glucose, Choco Chip biscuits are the examples of rotary molded biscuits. The third classification of the USA classification is wire cutting type. Here, the soft short dough is passed through holes in extruders and these doughs are then wire cut in pieces which are directly dropped into oven band. Butter cookies, chocolate cookies are some examples of wire cut type biscuits. The last one is the depositing type. The soft pourable short dough is passed out from extruder and directly laid on the baking bands. The depositor may rotate to make swirls and twist onto the product. Cream treat biscuits are made by this depositing type method. There are various established processes commercially available and being practiced by different manufacturers for the biscuit preparation. The process of manufacturing of biscuits mainly involves the following three steps: mixing, shaping or forming, baking. As the mixing and baking steps are common to manufacture of all types of biscuits, the differences in the finished product arises due to the different shaping and forming methods. Mixing process is commonly defined as a process designed to blend different ingredients into a uniform homogeneous mixture. The major ingredients are flour, fat, sugar and others as per the desired final one would like to have. For this step, all ingredients are put together in right proportion for the dough formation. These are then fed into mixers where mixing is done and dough is prepared for molding or cutting. There are three types of mixers being used for the mixing of ingredients: vertical spindle mixer, horizontal mixer and continuous mixer. For the mixing purpose, there are three types of mixers being used in the baking industry. The first one is the vertical spindle mixer. It contains a portable dough trough. Here, a spindle with horizontal paddle or arms is there. The dough is mixed by upward and downward movement. The mixer blades are for cutting action rather than kneading. These mixers are advantageous because of suitability for any product. However, the disadvantage lies in the slow operating speed. The another one is the horizontal mixer. Here, a horizontal bowl mounted on a rigid frame that encloses the dry motor is there. The mixer bowl is designed to tilt so as to eject the dough from the tilted position. Blades of variable shapes are there to perform the cutting, scraping or kneading action. The advantage of the horizontal mixer is that high speed, continuous dough supply to processing line, complete automation and uniform mixing. The last type of mixer is continuous mixer. Here, a rotor or screw operates within a barrel jacketed for temperature control. There is continuous feeding of the ingredients. The mixing is variable from gentle blending and dispersing to vigorous or high intensity kneading by varying the arrangements of different mixing arms along the length of the barrel. There is constant supply of dough to the processing line. This is small in size relative to the horizontal type. However, the disadvantages are it is suitable for single purpose or similar type of products only, hence causes a high cost. The forming process is specific for each biscuit or cookie type. There are three processes by which shaping or forming of biscuits is achieved. The first one is sheeting and cutting, rotary molding and extrusion. The shaping or forming process is, in the sheeting and cutting method of the forming, the ingredients are first mixed, dough is formed. There is a formation of thick sheet. There is even reduction of the sheet. The shape is cut and the dough pieces are formed. The scrap dough which is left is reincorporated and again passed through the similar process. So this is the sheeting and cutting method of shape formation. In the rotary molding, the dough is in the hopper. The dough is pulled down by feed roller and then it is forced into cavity of the engraved roller. Excess dough is scraped off, which is again incorporated into the dough present in the hopper. The dough pieces are dropped on a conveyor belt and the dough pieces are ready for the baking operation. In the extrusion process, in the hopper, the dough lies. The dough is forced into a pressure chamber and then extruded through the die. The extruded dough is cut by wire mounted on a frame, and then the dough pieces are dropped on a conveyor belt, and by this the pieces are ready for the baking. Baking, the biscuits are baked on a desired temperatures. Various type of heating are available nowadays as per the convenience and cost. Different types of oven are available for the baking of the products. After the baking step, the hot product obtained must be cooled to room temperature prior to packaging for several reasons. Being warm reduces firmness of the baked product so as to withstand packaging process. Packaging material shrinkage due to contact to hot product. Hot packed product may continue release some steam causing condensation inside the packaging. Cooling can be achieved either by placing the baked product at ambient conditions or by forced air cooling. For the simplest biscuit preparation, Whiteley method is used, and according to this method, the use formulation is given here. The various steps of biscuit manufacture, like ingredient mixing, cutting, baking, and cooling, are shown here. The Whiteley method of biscuit making, it encompasses creaming of the fat and sugar in a mixer, addition of well mixed blend of flour, baking powder and skimmed milk powder, addition and mixing of water containing sugar, salt, ammonium bicarbonate, sodium bicarbonate and flavor. Preparation of dough, sheeting into desirable shape, and baking at 200 degree centigrade for 8 to 9 minutes, followed by cooling and packaging. For the biscuit manufacturing processes, here are listed some of the most commonly used machineries. Concluding the module, we can see that biscuits have mass consumer acceptability and can be classified in different ways. As far as their manufacture is concerned, the basic ingredients used are flour, baking powder, salt, baking soda, sugar, shortening, and milk solids. Depending on the aesthetics and demand, numerous other ingredients are also used commercially. The main steps involved in biscuit manufacture are mixing, shaping or forming, baking, followed by cooling. There are different kinds of mixers for the mixing operation, such as vertical spindle mixer, horizontal mixer, and continuous mixer.